Hello, Star fam! We are here again in Rockville in the very old game Star Stable, the Spring Riders. This is the third game in the Star Stable Season Riders series, and now we are heading up to the shop again. I've just stayed overnight in one of the small shelters here to talk to Manny, the shop owner. I'm also going to open up my skill point list because I leveled up in the end of the last episode, and I'm going to add some skill points. So I'll be a more skilled rider. It's going to be easier for me to ride around on this incredibly slow horse. Manny thinks that his shop might use a little cheering up, so he would like to pick some beautiful spring flowers. Do you recognize this quest? You should, because this quest, the exact same quest, is used in Silverglade Village in Star Stable Online just as you get there. Felix, the shop owner, asks you to go out and pick some flowers for his shop. And yes, the quest is just literally copy-pasted from this game, which is probably because Star Stable Online was such a huge project. It was made by, I believe, an even smaller team than the team who made these four games. And some things had to be reused, and a lot of things were reused for that game. Here are the flowers. Yeah, because as you know in Star Stable Online, a lot of assets are recycled from these old games. These flowers, for example, when they have pink petals, they are the flowers of Aideen, like being in Veildale. Textures, bushes, some clothes and gear, horses, stables, houses, a lot of things were reused for Star Stable Online. And luckily, in the last couple of years, SSO has been able to remake a lot of things and make the game look prettier and more modern, because of course you don't really want your game 2018 to look like a game 2019 right now. I'm gonna blame it on me being very tired. It's quite late at night when I'm recording this because I didn't have time to do it previously and I've been at work all day, so I have the right to be tired, okay? So now Manny gets his flowers. He's gonna put them in a vase in the back room.
Hey.
But he would like a favor again. He would like us to post this note on the Rockville Stables placard. He would like to find someone special to share this spring with, and he doesn't really have the guts to ask anyone himself. So we are heading up back to the Rockville Stables to help him out, because we're good friends. So let's head back up here. I would like to build Rockville in The Sims one day. I've been planning to do that for quite a while, and I was like, don't really know how to do it because of the no terrain changes in The Sims, and now you can change the terrain heights in The Sims 4, so I'm like, know what I'm gonna do one day. Of course, that means I need to do it one day as well, and I haven't really... I don't know when I'm supposed to, because I don't really have time to. So, Manny says, spring is here, do you want to share it with me? I like long walks in the mountains and by the beach, cats and dogs and cartoons. Well, that sounds like a good guy. That's good. Jordan, do you have any quest for me apart from the medals?
No,
I don't want to compete. Because of course Jordan wants me to earn some medals. As you can see here, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 different races in this game. Very few in comparison to the last game. And then we have one huge trophy here in the middle. And that is for the great challenge at the end of the game. And in Swedish it's called the Rodilla Championship. I have no idea what it's called in English. I would guess it's the same thing. For now we're heading down again. We will not meet up with Manny at once, I believe. Let's see here. It looks like we're gonna talk to someone here down by the village. I believe it could be... Let's see here. Over here. Yeah. And in Swedish, I believe she's called Jenny. Let's see if she's called Jenny here too. Somehow, she magically saw the notice I posted up by the stables. And she thinks Manny is really cute. And she doesn't really need to tell him. Yeah, she's Jenny. So... yeah, let's go talk to Manny. I believe I even might get some stable points for this quest. There are a couple of quests within the game series where you actually get stable points. And stable points is the currency in this game. There's no such thing as star coins or Yorvik shillings. You will only have stable points. That's the currency you use. And he's like, oh, no, Jenny's far too pretty for me. But they're gonna meet up anyway. It's gonna be good. I did not get any stable points. Disappointed! Let's head down to... I'm gonna try to find a well to get some water for Bella. And Bella is my horse, if you have forgotten about that. Can I do this while mounted? Yes, thank you, game. So I'm just quickly going to give Bella some water. A really good thing in these old games, you are not limited to caring for your horses in a stable environment. You can do it anywhere you want, because sometimes you are stuck in the middle of nowhere, and it's good for you to be able to care for your horse wherever you are. Because the horse's well-being will go down quite quickly, so it's very important for you to be able to care for it at any time. I will need to buy some hay, but I don't have any money right now, so I can't. But I will soon. For now, let's head down to Johnny Black by the Rockville paddock. And see what he has in store for us. Because, as you might remember, in the last episode, Jordan asked us to go and meet Johnny. So let's do so. He's down here. He looks... well, scaringly similar to... one of the Summers brothers in Star Stable Online. And yeah, his name is Black. Johnny Black. It's not like you know someone else who introduces himself in that way. So of course Johnny is gonna be a riding instructor. You see the new golden star up here. And of course let's try out his course. We're gonna see what Dressage is all about in this game. And... this is not a very fancy game mechanic, but it works. And this, of course, will also help raise the stats of my horse, which I'm very grateful for. So, let's see here. This is not rocket science. It looks more difficult than it is. You see the arrows on the ground? Let's follow them. So now we're gonna start at a canter. Quite easy, we're just going to head towards the stars. Follow the lines on the ground. Very similar to the druid training in the sun circle or the taking care of foals in the Southwood Peninsula Rescue Ranch minigame. And as you can see, these arrows are reused for those purposes in Starship Online. And one of the... well, I think it's kind of controversial points in SSO is discussing why dressage is not a thing. And I'd say that having dressage as this thing would not be something that people would want to come back to and play after playing it 5 times. So that's why this is not a huge thing in SSO already, because it would not be fun for players in that sort of game. And also, high scores in a game like this would not be something that would be possible to kind of figure out. As you can see now, I just got all the stars, which means that yeah, I won. I can't do any better than this. As you can see here as well, I would have been cleared if I only took 91 stars, or not really stars, more like points. And this system is kind of strange anyway, so yeah. Yeah, but anyway, so. Dressage competitions in Star Stable Online, while dressage is something that the Star Stable team really wants to do, it's more important to do it well than to just get it out. And we leveled up again! This is going very quickly. I'm just going to continue to... oh well, am I? I'm gonna take 9. Yeah, it's good that I can count to 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Yeah. 1, 2, 3. Perfect! Johnny Black, what do you want to do? Moving up! He thinks that I'm progressing well. That's good. I've only been here for like 10 minutes. And he says Do you remember when I told you that dressage is the foundation for all riding? And he would like us to meet a girl who will also be an instructor here on the riding camps. She's called Lisa, and that's Lisa Peterson, the sole rider, and she's hired to run the shoreline paddock. And, well, that's a paddock located by the shoreline. I know, sounds insane. So we're going to head off to her place to do her dressage course. But I think let's go for the bronze medal here anyway, just to make sure that we have done it. Maybe we should try to take all the medals here at once. It's not like it's very difficult. Yeah, so here we are. And we do have some spectator stands over there. We cannot use them. They're just there for show, and there won't ever be anyone sitting in them in this game. This game is... I think this might be the shortest of all the games. And I think that, I mean, all the courses take quite long to finish because they demand some precision. But I think this really is the shortest of all the games, which I think is kinda sad. Because I do enjoy this game. I think it's very pretty. As I said previously, this game has the prettiest stables and villages in the entire series. And probably more like villages, because the stables do look the same all over. But I really enjoy this game. I do. But I also see some problematics with it. But mostly because it's so old. And if it would have had a bigger dev team, I guess it would have... You could have done more with it. And I'm not sure if I missed that star, but anyway, I succeeded, I got the bronze medal. So to get the medal, I need to go back to Johnny and talk to him, and I will get my medal up here. I really don't think that these old stars of games are bad games. But I think that they could use some glow up. I mean, if these games were to be remade by the current Star Stable team, no one would be happier than me, because I know what magic those guys can do. So, I really enjoy these games. I really, really, really wish that the areas you see in these old games one day will come to Star Stable Online. That's one of my greatest wishes for the entire product as SSO. I just want everything from these old games to show up again, especially just the areas. Like, imagine Rockville in the new graphic style, that would be also amazing. I really hope it will happen one day. And I know it's kind of like, Rockville has been mentioned a couple of times in game dialogue. I have no idea if that means that it will happen one day. I think it's mostly like just a fun Easter egg. So, anyway, a girl can dream. Right now we are going for the silver medal. I can get a maximum of 30 stars here, as you can see up here. I've just like forgotten how to count the points here because I haven't played this game in so long. But you do see some sort of score bar here. I have no idea how it works, to be fair. But I got all the stars. We're gonna head back to Johnny to get our medal. And the discipline stat is already maxed out, which is kinda sad because it's still very bad. So let's head on to take the gold medal, just to have it done. It feels a bit like the day cycle is very long in this game, but I think I'm just imagining it. It would be nice to be able to do an entire figure without the horse threatening to slow down, but you can't have it all, I guess. Still, this is the second episode, we're already at level 4. I think, isn't it that one level 4 horse up in the stables? I think it is. I don't want that one. I have been considering getting one of the horses from Bay Ridge. Actually, a Frisian horse. I know that sounds super fancy, but it's not really, because all the horses in this game had the same model. Well, there is two models, to be fair. This is the one that I'm currently riding, and the one slightly slimmer one. I think it's only two. So, it would be fun if we had more horses, but we don't. But anyway, Frisian, so it's basically one of these horses black. I'm considering it simply because it could be fun. Gold medal, yahoo! But I don't know. I think we're gonna do at least three horses throughout this playthrough. Maybe four, depends a bit. Depends a bit on what you guys want as well. If you want me to buy a lot of horses, maybe I will. But I don't think that any of the horses in Rockville will be super fun to ride. If we have a look at the map, take a look at the map, we see that we are here. Here is Rockville. We have Lisa at the Shoreline Paddock up here. At a later point we'll find Alex down here. We will be able to head out here on the grey area. Here we have Bay Ridge. Bay Ridge is run by a man named Ronnie Bob Summers, and you might be like, where have I heard that name? Yeah, you see, he has four kids who somehow are scattered around the entire area of Jorvik in Starship Online. They are called Courtney, Marnie, Marley, Barney, and Carney. Yeah, not Marnie, Marley. So, yeah, those three knuckleheads and their sister, their dad is hanging around here. Along with a secret extra child. I'm gonna talk more about that later because that's super interesting, really. But I think I need to earn some money. And I know I said in the last episode that I might not show the stable shores, but I need some money to be able to buy hay. So let's just do the stable shores once so we can get it out of the way and just talk a bit more about the game. And maybe we should go for the medals up here as well. I don't really want to because this horse is so slow. Maybe I should wait until I buy a slightly faster horse. But I did level up. Do you have anything else for me? No, you don't. I don't want to talk to you then. Bye. So, this is just some long copy down here. She has a lot of things to say. I don't really care because we know how to do this. And I always want to press X to dismount and I realize that, oh, this is not SSO. We don't have any hotkeys in this game. So sad. But anyway. And then I tried to press shift to run and I realized that no, it's just that the toggle doesn't work. So, I mean, as long as I just press W, she's gonna start running sooner or later. And if I press shift, she's gonna stop and it's gonna like, they're gonna think that I'm trying to stop. Which is super annoying because I'm just doing the Star Stable way and also the Star Train Legacy way. So yeah, just gonna care for the horses in here. To get myself some money. And, I mean, I do understand why they decided to put a bunch of level 5 horses here. Because if I take all the medals in Jordan's competition, I guess I will reach level 5. But I think you'll find some level 2 horses in Bay Ridge. And that's kind of strange. But also, the stables are located really close to each other in this game. This is a very small area. It doesn't feel like a small area, but it is. Especially, it feels especially like Bovista, which is the last area of the game. Or last stable you'll reach in the game. It feels like that's really off from the other places. It's not really. And I always have difficulties going back to Rockville because as I mentioned in the last episode, there's a lot of pots in this game. And they all seem to lead to different places. They do lead to the same place, but you have to run for so long to get anywhere. So it's like all roads lead to Rome, but you're gonna visit all the other countries first. So now we're just gonna take care of the horses. You can, of course, take care of all the horses. Or, well, you can do all the chores with one horse if you want. Horse. Oh, English. But I prefer to do the mucking first and then go back and do all the other three chores because I think that's the most time efficient thing to do. And also, thanks to some bugs do warm my heart, and one of them is that if you care for horses in these games, your horse will be cared for too, so I don't need to buy hay immediately, which is really nice. I do need to... Bella, where are you? I want to brush you. And as you can see, her health is going up, which is really good. I want her to stay healthy. Even though I don't really care for this particular horse, I do want my horse to be well cared for. Okay, Jordan, please give me some money. Yeah, so he's gonna click this draw. You can always pause the video if you want to read what she's saying. And yeah, this is like FAQ stuff, so if you don't know how to play the game, you can read this. I know how to play the game, believe it or not. I've been playing this game for like 10 years, so I'm good. You can see stable points up here. You get 180 stable points here for doing all the chores. You will earn more money in the other games. The other games. In the other stables. Now I'm really tired. But I think that's fitting anyway, because we have been taking 3 medals today. We've done a couple of quests. I think we're good to end for today, even though the night isn't really falling yet, because we won't really have time to do anything else anyway. So it's gonna be perfect for us to end off here. Thank you all so much for watching. I am really happy that you want to join me on this journey throughout these old games. And I'm having a blast. I mean, this is really fun. And I do love these games. I do complain a bit, but I do really, really love them. These games were my childhood. And I'm currently working with the people who made these games. So I'm really happy to be able to go back and see how they evolved too in their game making. And also how the IP evolved. I'm very happy about that. Once again, if you do have horse name suggestions for future horses I'm gonna buy, leave them in comments down below. If you just want to talk about the game, leave another comment. It's super fun to have discussions with you. Please leave a like if you like the video. And if you haven't done so already, don't forget to subscribe to see more horse game videos coming every single week. Especially on Sundays, because then we have this series and this is always happening, even if I don't have time to do anything else. So, yeah, that's it for today. I really hope to see you all next time.